Hi, my name is Nasser Mohammadi and I am one of the application engineers at Texas Instruments high-speed signal conditioning products. In this video, we are going to discuss how to reconstruct eye diagrams from high-speed signal conditioning devices. Also, we are going to discuss two registers which represent the overall incoming signal health and conditions. The LMH12XX or other high-speed signal conditioning devices on-chip eye monitor is used to analyze post-equalized signal. Incoming signals go through either 75-ohm coax or 50-ohm PCB trace or media. After equalization and retiming, the signal is sampled in both phase and voltage domain using a phase DAC and a voltage DAC for 1 UI worth of signal. 1 UI of eye capture could be either from midpoint to midpoint or from eye crossing to eye crossing. This depends on the device. Point to remember is that we capture one whole unit interval of the eye diagram. The phase and voltage DAC range, which is called PDAC and VDAC respectively, have 64 steps each. This results into an array of 64 by 64 cells. Delta or differences between two adjacent vertical cells specifies number of hits or number of times signal passes through a cell. For example, waveform on the right is the raw data containing 64 by 64 cells. If a cell value doesn't change with respect to the previous vertical cell, or if it is zero, this means there is no hit or eye crossing. Please bear in mind, number of hits at each point should be normalized to determine the probability for a specific hit count to occur. Then this can be color-coded to get the eye diagram that we are very familiar with. Shortly, we will describe this in much more details. One way we can capture or check incoming signal integrity is by eye-opening capture. Another method is to simply read two registers, HEO or horizontal eye-opening and VEO vertical eye-opening. These two registers gives us a good indication of the incoming signal health. Let's first quickly discuss HEO and VEO, and then we would look much more deeper into how to capture eye opening. HEO is horizontal eye opening while VEO is vertical eye opening. Please note these measurements correspond to inside the eye diagram. For example, when your signal goes through a lossy media, HEO and VEO gets reduced or the eye diagram gets shrunken, as shown in this eye diagram. HEO is at the maximum horizontal eye opening, while VEO is the maximum vertical eye opening, specified in millivolt, versus HEO is specified in percentage of the whole eye opening, or UI, unit interval. Value of HEO is reported in hex format. This should be first converted to decimal and then divided by 64 to get a percentage of eye opening. For example, if HEO value is 20, this would be 32 decimal, and 32 divided by 64, we would get 50% horizontal eye opening. Also, for VEO, we always multiply after conversion to decimal by 3.125 millimol per step. Please note, VEO does not have a one-to-one correlation with incoming signal voltage swing. To make this point more clear, let's look at a couple of measurements I made. Here, what I did was to use BERT and change its differential voltage swing. Then we measured VEO and HEO as reported by the device. VEO is post-equalized amplitude and it is just a figure of merit. Therefore, as shown in this graph, it is linear up to a certain point, and it doesn't have a one-to-one correlation with the incoming signal. Overall, as long as we are above 150 millivolt, we should be able to operate error-free. Note, VEO is more linear for lower data rates, right here 6G, 3G and HD, versus higher data rates at 12G. Also, given the overall jitter tolerance, for error-free operation, we need at least 0.45 UI of hue. In summary, main criteria for error-free operation is when we have VEO greater than 150 millivolt and hue greater than 0.45 UI. Next, let's see how eye diagram is captured or how it is done internally. More importantly, we discuss how 64 by 64 cells data is streamed out of the device. To visualize this, imagine we have two waveforms, a reference waveform and an offset waveform that is superimposed on reference waveform. Additionally, we put a 64 by 64 cells or window on top of these two waveforms. Where these two waveforms cross one another, we have eye crossing or eye hits that is recorded on the corresponding cells or window. Please note, for this measurement, PDAC, which is the horizontal axis, is held constant while VDAC, vertical axis, is swept from the lowest number 1 through 64. Once this is done, PDAC is incremented. We go to the next column. And again, VDAC is swept from 1 to 64. This continues until we go to the maximum PDAC of 64 and maximum VDAC of 64. Once this is done, we have our 64 by 64 cells or matrix, and its cell value could be used to determine eye crossing. To show how data gets streamed out of the device, I capture data using a clock pattern. To make our discussion easier, when we refer to cell 1, 2, for example, it means PDAC 1 and VDAC 2. Here I capture 64 by 64 cells. This is basically 64 rows with 64 columns. For clarification, I have zoomed into the first two and the last two columns. Raw data begins at cell 1, 1 with a value of 7681 and continues until there is a drop to 2972. This is cell 120, a delta of about 4700. Then it drops back to zero, from 2972 to zero. Again, at cells 1, 46 or row 46, we see a big jump to 7674. Once column 1 on the far left is streamed out from top to bottom, the next column begins with cell 2, 1 through cell 2, 64 right here. This continues until we go through our 64 by 64 cells or matrix. Please note, there could be a case where we don't have or where we don't see a clear eye boundary like what I have shown here. There is a register called range register which sets the capture range like a camera apparatus control that determines how much of the image or signal we are going to capture. If this settings is too low, we will not capture the whole eye diagram. For this measurement, I use the highest range settings. Now that we have our 64 by 64 cells, let's build our eye diagram externally. I use Excel for this task and let's see how this is done. For this measurement, the hardware setup is as follows. I have a bird going to LMH1228EVM, followed by 3 meter of Belden 1694A cable, and then LMH1219 EVM. And this is where I capture eye opening. We have 6 waveforms for this test. And I use, just for the sake of simplicity, for this test, I use a simple clock pattern. First waveform is the actual raw data that we captured. We captured this data like what we just described in the previous page. In second waveform, we subtract adjacent vertical cells from one cell to another cell. To make this simple, I used absolute value of delta between two adjacent cells. As you can see, at eye crossing, there is 4 or 5 bands right here where we have some numbers. This is simply due to limitation of the sampling of the incoming waveform. For next step, we calculate maximum hits from 64 by 64 cells of this waveform number 2, and we use this maximum hit to normalize the whole 64 by 64 cells of waveform number 2, and we create waveform number 3. Additionally, also, we have color-coded waveform number 3 based on the normalized values. For waveform number 4, it is the same as waveform number 3, but we have cleaned up hits that are by themselves, like right here. Again, these are due to undersampling that I noted earlier. In waveform number 5 and 6, we have zoomed in waveform number 4 in order to calculate HEO and also calculate VEO. So for VEO calculations, we count the number of rows right here. We have 28 rows, and each row is 12.5 millivolt per step. Therefore, the eye opening, the maximum vertical eye opening, is 350 millivolt. Here we followed the same exact procedure as before, but instead we used LMH1219 EVM with 50 meter of belting cable instead of 3 meter. Additionally, also, we use PRBS pattern instead of clock pattern. Again, waveform number 1 is our raw data before doing any processing. Then waveform number 2 is the vertical subtraction of the two adjacent cells. And waveform number 3 and 4 are the same as what we just described earlier. Using this diagram, we calculate again jitter. Jitter is like 22 columns right here, and 22 divided by 64, that's about 0.35 UI. And 1 minus 0.35, it means basically we have 0.65 UI of horizontal eye opening. Also, we have 25 rows, 25 times 12.5 or 312 millivolt vertical eye opening. In summary, the on-chip eye-opening monitor can be used for development and remote field support. Eye-opening capture is non-disruptive. This means eye-opening can be captured while user data is going through the device. HEO / VEO numbers are numerical representation of the health of the incoming signal. And these are two registers that could be read very easily. Additionally, these registers can be option to cause interrupt if certain threshold is reached, making this very convenient for constant signal quality observation and checking. Please refer to the programming guide for detailed register settings for HEO, VEO and eye opening capture. I'd like to thank you very much for watching this video, and please visit ti.com for further documentations and send me emails in case there is a question. Thank you very much.